So why not create a method to help us print an array? And whichever array we pass into it, it's the same. The code is basically this. The code is basically the same. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and create a method. Again, let's call it public, void, static. I'll shortly explain all of these three words, what they mean and how to use them. And let's call it print array. And what do we take as a parameter? Well, we take int array. Sorry, it's public static void. Okay, the order matters. Okay, int, let's call it array or whatever we want to call it. And now we just want to, I'm just going to copy this bit of code, paste it here and replace A3 with array. Okay, so, and get rid of ln. And for example, if you really want to be nice about it, I'm just going to go out and print out an open bracket. And at the end, I'm going to go and print out a closed bracket just so the array looks nice, you know, with the brackets and everything. And I'm going to add a comma as well after each element. So now you see what I'm trying to do here. We're trying to do something like 1, 2, 3, closed bracket, right? This is how we want to print out our arrays, just so it's nice, right? Okay, and now we can get rid of all of this and we can call our method three times, print array A1, print array A2, print array A3. Okay, and I wanna have this not be print line and I wanna have this be actually print line because I want it to, when it prints an array, I want it to go to the next row. So let's run this and see what we get. Okay, so you can see now why methods are useful. Basically, when reading this code, like imagine you haven't written this code, you're just reading my code. When you see this print array and you pass A1, it immediately basically tells you what's gonna happen. When you've seen like the for loop, what does this do? I mean, you can analyze it, of course. This is a simple for loop, it's pretty obvious what it does, but this is more obvious. It prints the array, right? So always name your methods some, you know, normal smart names. Don't name your method which prints array, don't name it print. Or I mean, you can name it print, but don't name it P, you know. Name it print array, that's the best, but you, if you want to, you can name it print, but you know, don't name it something that you will forget what it does, you know. So one thing that I wanted to point out, we have an extra comma here. Can anybody provide a solution? How do we get rid of the comma at the end? We can break, yeah, but yeah. So basically, we don't need to add a comma always. We will add a comma under some condition, right? Okay, sorry, I got rid of the closed curly. So now we're gonna say if something, something, add a comma. And what's inside of here? What goes inside of this if statement? When do we wanna add a comma and when do we not? What goes inside of if? Something about the array and the length, yeah, but can you, yeah, if I is, yeah, it's something about array.length minus one, exactly. So we only want to print out the comma if I is everything but the last element, and the last element is array.length minus one. It's basically similar to what Tomislav and Vicky said, but maybe somewhere in between. So basically we want to print out a comma if I is less than array.length minus one. Why not just array.length? Well, because that's all the elements. This is, we already have that condition for stopping the loop, you know, so we must subtract one element. This is one way to do it. Because we have a print line here, everything messed up. The other way to do it would have been to invert the condition, to always to have a break if I is equal to the last element. Basically, if I equals to array.length minus one, then break, otherwise print out. You know, you understand that. It's basically like this. If I is array.length minus one, then break or something, and then we print out the comma if we haven't broken. So let's comment this out and run it like this and see what happens. Oh my God, I have print line again. Okay, run again. And now it just works again, right? Those are the two ways that we can do it.